Let me do a different problem. Maybe. Yeah. Question is same question. Draw a graph for the system and mark the feasible region. If it exists. Okay, so let me do the first one, that is x plus y minus 3 greater than equal to 0, and second one is 2x plus y minus 4 greater than. See, earlier I was giving you some equations, but one at a time, but now I am giving two equations at the same time, so you have to draw the both the straight line and solve for both the thing. So let us start. So to draw a straight line, first write the it should be zero. So to draw, let us first solve this, that is put the straight line, that is forget about inequality, x plus y minus 3, put it 0, correct? Then what next? This will be x plus y equal to 3. You require 2 points to plot. Can you give me 2 points which satisfy the equation? If you are not that much good, then you can put y is equal to 3 minus x. Put x equal to 0 and get the value of y. Put y equal to 0, get the value of x. That thing is quite good. If you put x equal to 0, what will be the value of y? In the equation, if you put x equal to 0, what will the value of y?
3.
And if you put y is equal to 0, then what will be the value of x? 3, perfect. So you have got 2 points, is that clear? You require only 2 points to draw the graph, I hope that is clear to you. Yes? And what about this thing? That is 2x plus y minus 4, put equal to 0, then what? This will be 2x plus y is equal to 4. Next, again you can do the same thing, put y is equal to 4 minus 2x. Put two values. Suppose I am putting y equal to 0. Sorry, x equal to 0. If you put x equal to 0, what is the value of y? 4. And if you put y equal to 0, then what is the value of x? Is that clear, everyone? Y 0, then it will be 2x equal to 4, x equal to 2. Very nice. Good. Now let us check which of them is origin side or non-origin side. Correct? So I will just keep some places here to write it later on. Let us first draw the graph. Whether it is origin side or non-origin side, we'll write it later. Let us first draw the graph. So mostly see, in my graph, all the points are positive. Correct? So I'll draw the first quadrant only, but that is not required. It depends on your equations. I'll talk about this later on maybe. So say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Do I require go to, yeah, maximum limit is 4 only, so that is okay. 1, 2, 3 and say 4. So let us draw the first line. So 0, 3 and 3, 0. So what is that? This is 30 and this is 03. So first put the points, then draw a straight line. Is that clear to you? Oh, sorry, actually drawing in this thing is quite difficult, drawing a straight line, something like that. Okay, and what about the second line? 04 and 20. 20 means here it is, and 04 means here it is. Okay, perfect. Let us draw the graph. Oh, I'm sorry, actually it is quite difficult to draw by hand here. There is some softwares which can directly draw, but that is time consuming, so I hope that is okay to you. Yeah, so we are having the graph now. Let us see which of them is origin side or non-origin side. Do you understand what do you mean by origin side? See, look at this straight line. Forget about this one. Look at the first straight line. Okay, I'll write one first straight line and check this line is dividing your graph into two parts. One part is this side and one part is this side. In one part there is origin, correct? So this part I will say as origin side and this part I'll say non-origin side. Is that okay? Now if origin is satisfying by the equation, then I'll say it is the origin equation is satisfying origin side, then it is origin side. So let us, you just have to put 0 0 in the equation. So if you put 0 0, then this will be x 0 y 0, that is minus 3 is greater than equal to 0. Is that correct? Whether minus 3 is greater than 0? No. So this will be non-origin side. Is that clear, everyone? Non-origin side means what? The graph will be something going up. I'll just write like this. Okay. What next? What about this guy? Again put 0, 0. So this will be? Yes. Minus 4, that is greater than 0. Again non-origin side. So this is also going perfect. So this is also going this side. Correct. And what will be the common region? This guy is showing go there and this guy is also showing go there. So what will be the common region? Common to both the thing. See, if I am talking about this part, only this part, so this is not common to this guy. Common with respect to this line. Do you agree? So tell me which region is common to both the graph, both the thing. Do you see this one? I'll just put it with the different color maybe. So this part is satisfied by both the equation. If I have included this thing, then this line is not satisfying. This region is not satisfying. So whatever this part is, this is my feasible region. Is that clear, everyone? Do you agree? Perfect. Can somebody tell me how can I find the intersection point? If I want to find the intersection of a two line, how can I do that? What do you mean by intersection? This point is satisfied by this equation also, and this point is satisfied by this equation also. So how can I find this point, intersection point? This is satisfied by both the equation. That means what? You can do simultaneous equation. Do you remember 10th standard or 9th standard? If you solve two equations by putting any two variables same, either you see y is same here. So if you subtract them, then you will get the value of x, and you put it in the equation, then you will get the value of y. Then that will be your intersection point. Actually that points are satisfied by that point is satisfied by both the lines. Is that clear? Yes. Good. Okay, so if you are having this type of question, I hope that is okay. You can do. Yes. Okay. Now, if my question was, draw the line in the x-axis, in the first quadrant only, then the same graph in the first quadrant only, then this graph was restricted up to first quadrant only. You don't have to go here, correct? This was restricted up to here and here also. And you already know what are the, in the first quadrant, both positive, correct? X is also positive, y is also positive. Here, tell me. Okay, what about this? Okay, what about this? Perfect, very nice. So you should consider this is positive values, this is also positive values, this is negative value, but this guy is positive, so this is negative positive. Here both the people are negative, so that's why this is negative, this is something like that. Okay, yeah. So shall we do one more problem based on this? Let us do one more, then we'll go to the next part, that is LPP. The question is same, draw the graph. I'll just put the equation 4x plus 6y greater than 45 and 2x plus 3y less than 6. Okay, will you do that? Will you try quickly? What you have to do? Find the two points and tell me quickly. Put equal to here and put a line here, that will be good thing. And this will be 2x plus 3y and less, sorry, that should be equal to 6. So put some values and tell me the two points which is satisfying the equation. And now please check, once you get the points, please check whether that is satisfying the equation or not. That is important. If I put y equal to 0, then will I get something? I think not, no. That is not suitable. That will be 45 by 4, that is not okay. And that's also no issue, you can do that. See, if I put y equal to 0, then what I will get? 45 by 4. If I put x equal to 0, then it will be 45 by 6. Is that clear? But that is not good thing to do. But अभी के केस में चलेगा अपने को ग्राफिकली. जस्ट वी आर डूइंग रैंडमली अ क्वेश्चन, देन दिट इज ओके. सो यहाँ पे क्या आएगा? इफ आई पुट वाई इक्वल टू जीरो, इफ आई पुट एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो, टेल मी. दिस विल बी थ्री, दिस विल बी टू ना, टू. ये यस, वेदर इट इज ओरिजिन साइड और नॉन ओरिजिन साइड, कैन यू टेल मी? चेक द फर्स्ट वन, पुट जीरो जीरो इन साइड इट, वट डू यू सी? जीरो जीरो इज टेलिंग ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 45, इज इट ट्रू? नॉन ओरिजिन साइड, वेरी नाइस. वट अबाउट दिस गाय? वट अबाउट दिस वन? परफेक्ट, वेरी नाइस, ओरिजिन साइड, गुड. सो लेट अस ड्रॉ. I'll just roughly draw. The first one is 45 by 4, 0, and 0 45 by 6. Where this will be 45 by 4, it will be somewhere here. Say 45 by 4, 45 by 6 somewhere here. 0 and 6. So graph will be something like this. Correct? Something like this. Okay. So this is L1. You can say 45 by 4, this is 45 by 6. Okay, what about the second point? 0, 2, and 2, 0, na something? Oh, 3, 0, and 0, 2. 3, 0, see, 45 by 4 bada hai ki 3 bada hai? Which one is bigger? Whether 3 is bigger or 45 by 4? 3 is bigger. ये 45 बाय 4, यू राइट, पुट द टेबल. 4 टेन्स आर 40, सो इट इज अराउंड 11, हाँ. सो 3 विल बी समवेयर हियर ओनली. 45 6 बड़ा है कि 2 बड़ा है? इट विल बी समथिंग हियर ओनली. दिस अ वेरी बिग नंबर, यू जस्ट ट्राई टू डिवाइड. मैं something like this. That may intersect somewhere later on, but I'm just trying to draw this. Okay. Actually, that won't intersect anywhere. These are parallel lines. I'll tell you quickly one more. See, if you remember that slope of equation, if you are having an equation like this, that is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, then slope is given by minus b by a. Correct? If slopes are equal, then lines are parallel. If the multiplication of slope is minus 1, then we say that line is perpendicular. Do you see what is the slope for this? Minus b by a, that is minus 6 by 4. So that is same as 3 by 2, minus 3 by 2. And what about slope of this? This is again minus 3 by 2. So these two lines are parallel lines actually. So they will not intersect anywhere. Okay, what about this guy? Origin side ki non-origin side hai ye, 45 wala? Non-origin tha shayad. So this is telling go here. So this guy is telling me to go there and this guy is telling me to come here. Do I have any common region? Okay, so no solution. Answer is no solution. Do you agree? Because I wanted to find the values which are satisfied by both the equation. That means I wanted to find the common region. Do you agree? Here this guy is telling me to go there, this guy is telling me to go there. But I don't have anyone who is telling the same way. That is, this is also telling the same way. Even this was also saying the same way, then that way was correct. Now I am confused where to go, whether this or this. So I don't have any options, so no solution. Is that clear? Yes? Good. Okay, so let me start now. What is the meaning of LPP? First, let us understand. Okay. This is called LPP. LPP is the problem of optimization. Optimization means what? Maximization or minimization. Whatever. Of a linear expression in a certain number of variable variables where the variables are to satisfy some conditions, that is called constraints. In the form of linear inequalities. Or equations, whatever it may be. Okay. So, do you just read the question once again? Read the question. What do you see? So, what is the use of LPP first? Basically, example, you want to minimize the cost of production and maximize the profit. Something like that. We'll see some problem, then that will be quite clear to you. Let us see how to write LPP. Okay. Is that clear? Hello. Read the definition, you will get to know. Yeah. So let us see how to write. The first is objective function. Objective function means in the equation you will be writing maximized, let me maximize or minimize, whatever it may be, minimize z is equal to some equation. See, let me take an example, 4x plus 4y. So this will be the first part to write, objective function. The next part will be constraint. What are the constraint? You just have to write, you just forgot about this bracket. If you forget about this bracket, then your equation, that will be your LPP. So what will be your constraint? Constraint will be z equal to this, right, subject to the conditions. Let me just quickly write some conditions. Say 4x plus 5y is less than equal to 35, and say 5x plus 7y is less than equal to 34, something like that. And if you want one more condition, then also you can do. So these are the condition of subject to, and next is non-negative condition. Non-negative condition means what? X is positive and Y is positive. Okay, your LPP is divided into three parts. That is, if I write all together, then your LPP will look like this. Maximize z equal to 4x plus 5y subject to, that is 4x plus 5y less than equal to 35, and 5x plus 7y, that is less than equal to 34, and x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0. This is how your linear programming problem look like. This may, what is this guy? This is your objective function. You already know this. Z equal to, this is called objective function. And what is this thing? This is called constraints. And this is called non-negative condition. Is that clear? So to find, to write LPP problem, you require three things. First of all, you have to decide what is X and what is Y, and what do you want to maximize or minimize. So that will be your maximization problem. Is that correct? Is that okay? Yeah. Let us see some problem, then we'll quickly understand. So you just try to remember your LPP problem consists of three things. That is, one is objective function, and second is maximize. I'll just quickly give you some example without giving you the let us see formulation. Actually, formulation is important here. Let me quickly give you how to write first. Like this, maximize z is equal to 10x plus 15y, and subject to conditions 10x plus 5y, that is less than equal to 3000, and say 5x plus 10y, that is less than equal to 6000, then x plus y, that is less than 500. This may have so many conditions, okay? There is no issue. Where x is positive, y is positive. So what is the objective function here? This part is your objective function. What is the constraint? This is the constraint. Constraint means having inequality. Correct? And what is the non-negative condition? This is the non-negative condition. Is that clear? No, am I having some time? What is the timing? 11:34, no, I think. I'm having some time, no? Okay, so let us do some problem. I have already given. Yeah, you can take the screenshot or something. You just read the question and think about it. See, all the LPP problems work on a table. If you are able to create a table, then you are done actually. Let us see. Two different kinds of food A and B are being considered. So you are having two types of food. So let me start writing the. So this is food A, and let me write food B. Start creating a table whenever you see LPP problem, then your life will be quite easy. So you are having two food from weekly. The minimum weekly requirement of fats, carbohydrate and protein. So there are three things which are variable here: fats, carbohydrate and protein. And I write here only, and if I could, then that is very nice. Yeah. So food A and food B. Okay, so what are the three factors? And see, 1 kg of food A contains this much of fat, carbohydrate and protein. So for each of them, the variables are fats, carbohydrates, carbs and protein. Do you see, I can form a table here with the data. If you can form a table, then your life is very nice, very easy actually. You don't have to struggle in a problem of LPP if you can make the table. That's it. Okay, yeah. And actually, minimum requirement is also given. That is, you have to use minimum that much only. Okay, so let us see. 1 kg of food A has 5 units of fat. So where should I put? Food A, fat, 5 units. Do you agree? Yes, what about this? 15 units. Food A, carbohydrate. Do you see? You should be able to put it properly. And next is 8. Do you agree? And what about this? 7. Next 10. And next 9. Is that clear, everyone? Yeah, perfect. So yeah, good. So do you see, all the things we are talking about, food A and food B. So you can consider this food A as X and food B is Y. Correct? And this much amount of food A, this much amount of food B, something like that. And do you see minimum fat kitna apne paas? Minimum weekly requirement of fat. That means we cannot cross that limit. फैट मैक्सिमम अपना मिनिमम इतना ही है अपने पास. व्हाट इज दैट मिनिमम? 16. एंड नेक्स्ट 25. एंड नेक्स्ट इज 15. परफेक्ट. इज दैट क्लियर? वंस यू आर हैविंग अ टेबल लाइक दिस, देन यू कैन क्लियरली सी योर इक्वेशन. 5x प्लस 7y लेस देन इक्वल टू 16. डू यू सी द इक्वेशन? 5x, 7y. Why I'm putting less than equal to 16? Oh, sorry. Should I put less than equal to? See, it is minimum requirement. Huh? That means, agar fat, protein, ye sab jada hua, tabhi bhi chalega, koi problem nahi hai. But minimum mere ko itna chahiye. That means it should be greater than, I think, correct? So first equation will be 5x plus 7y. That should be greater than 16 से कम नहीं होना चाहिए. दैट्स इट. दैट शुड बी ग्रेटर देन. एंड व्हाट अबाउट द नेक्स्ट लाइन? 15x प्लस 10y दैट इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 25. एंड नेक्स्ट 8x plus 9y, that is greater than equal to 15. Do you agree? So do you see, this is the second part. Actually, we have got the constraint of your LPP, correct? This is constraint of your LPP. What we require now, objective function, and your non-negative is already given, that is that cannot be negative, no? Food x and food y, they cannot be negative, so they will be always either zero or positive. So we are having two parts, that is constraint also and non-negative condition. We just require objective function. Now what do you want to do? Right, look at the last line. The price of food A is 4 per kg and food B is 3 per kg. Form LPP to minimize. So first word will be minimize. Z is equal to, what is the price for food A? 4 kg. So perfect, 4x plus 3y. Is that clear, everyone? Is that clear? Very nice. Okay, so this is actually this is your final answer. This is what you have to find, but before that you should write what is x and what is y. I just quickly tell you by putting the table, but you should put what is x and what is y before that only. So what you can do, you can keep some space here and put the table here, then you just define what is your x and what is y. Let me write. Let x kgs of food A and y kgs maybe of food B be the weekly diet. Weekly diet. Then after that, make the table. Perfect. Put the inequalities. Then later on, your LPP will be, what will you write final? Question was form the LPP, no? So in the last, write the LPP is, what was the LPP? Z equal to kya tha? Sorry. First you have to write minimize or maximize. So write minimize. Z equal to 4x plus 3y, no? Subject to, what is the condition? You see, 5x plus 7y greater than equal to 16. Why it is greater than equal to 16? It is minimum requirement. You just want minimum. Jada hua to chalega. 5x plus 7y greater than equal to 16. What is the next one? Kya tha? Please. Okay. 15x plus 10y, that is greater than equal to 25. What is the last one? Very nice, okay. And what is the next part? Where x is positive and y is positive. Is that clear? Do you understand? You just have to form the table. That's it. Your LPP is done. Yes? Shall we do the next question? Do you see the question? Read the question properly. What should I put x and what should I put y? Oh, here they have used x and y, so we must put x1 x2 something. Think about it, it is quite a tricky question. You just read the question, you will see all the thing is given to you if you read this part properly. At least 100 unit of crystalline x गैसोलिन एक्स एंड 80 यूनिट्स ऑफ वाई रिक्वायर्ड। गैसोलिन का ये दे दिया, दैट मीन्स वॉट यू सी दैट योर हियर इन दिस केस योर रिक्वायरमेंट इज वन मोर गाय, दे हैवंट पुट वन मोर कॉलम मस्ट बी हियर समथिंग, करेक्ट? मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट, यस, फॉर सम इट इज मिनिमम एंड फॉर सम इट विल बी मैक्सिमम आई थिंक। या द प्रॉफिट 412 प्रॉफिट इज गिन, या हियर सी ऑप्टिमम, या ओके, रीड द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपरली, लेट अस स्टार्ट। व्हाट शुड आई पुट एक्स एंड व्हाट शुड आई पुट वाई? सी इफ माय टेबल वाज लाइक दिस, दैट इज 1 2 3, एंड हियर वाज द कंडीशन, करेक्ट? मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट वाज हियर, देन एक्स और वाई क्या पुट किया था मैंने, इसको एक्स पुट किया था, इसको वाई पुट किया, सो दैट मल्टीप्लाइंग एंड विल गेट द इनइक्वालिटी। नाउ माई टेबल इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट यहाँ पे है, मिनिमम रिक्वायरमेंट, करेक्ट? सो डेफिनेटली एक्स यहाँ पे होएगा, वाई यहाँ पे होएगा, मल्टीप्लीकेशन मल्टीप्लीकेशन इनइक्वालिटी, डू यू सी दैट? सो योर लाइफ इज ईजी, दैट इज टेबल तो दिया है तुमको, तो तुमको कुछ ज़्यादा मेहनत नहीं करना है, यू जस्ट हैव टू डिसाइड एक्स एंड वाई क्या रहेगा, एंड दैट इज वो डिसाइड होएगा लास्ट लाइन पढ़ के, द प्रॉफिट पर प्रोडक्शन फ्रॉम द प्रोसेस वन एंड प्रोसेस एंड टू आर, ओके दिस इज द प्रॉफिट, सो डेफिनेटली यू हैव टू कंसिडर दिस एज एक्स एंड दिस इज वाई, करेक्ट? सो यू शुड राइट लेट द प्रोडक्ट मिक्स, एक्चुअली दिस आर द मिक्स, लेट द प्रोडक्ट मिक्स of process 1 that is x and process y, so sorry x and y नहीं बोलते because y ये लोग ने use किया है x and y, so it is better to write x1 and x2, so just read the question and see what are the conditions, what is the availability of crude A, what are the maximum crude A, do you see the first line? Oh, I should erase this whole thing, then let us quickly do. Do you see the inequalities? Suppose you are considering, let me write here only, let the product, x1 and x2, two processes 1 and 2 लिखना चाहिए था actually, we hope that is okay, ठीक है? So for crude A it will be 5x1 plus 4x2 and what is the see maximum amount available, so this is maximum amount available for crude A, it is 200, so this will be less than equal to 200, do you agree? And what about the second crude B? It will be 3x1 plus 5x2, that is less than equal to, it is also maximum amount, so that is less than equal to 150, do you agree everyone? Perfect. Next, what about next for gasoline X? They are saying at least, huh, at least 100 units, that means it will be 5x1 plus 4x2, that at least means इतना minimum तो होना ही चाहिए, ज़्यादा हुआ तभी भी चलेगा, and what was next, gasoline y 80 units ना, so it will be 8x1 plus 4x2, that is greater than equal to 80 units, perfect, so you are having these four equations here, and non-negative condition is also given because these people cannot be negative, so can you give me quickly objective function, what is the objective function, Anyone, can you give me the objective function? Perfect. That is जो लास्ट लाइन रहेगा वो तुम्हें थ्री जेड इक्वल टू 3000x + 4000y, दिस इज योर ऑब्जेक्टिव फंक्शन. लिखेंगे कैसे फर्स्ट? मैक्सिमाइज ना, दैट इज मैक्सिमाइज जेड इक्वल टू 3000x1 + 4000x2. देन आफ्टर दैट सब्जेक्ट टू योर फोर कंडीशंस जो भी हम लोग ने लिखा है, एंड लास्ट में x1 इज पॉजिटिव एंड x2 इज पॉजिटिव. दिस इज योर थिंग. इज दैट क्लियर? कैन यू डू दैट? ओके गुड. आई विल गिव वन क्वेश्चन फॉर यू टू ट्राई. यू जस्ट प्लीज टेक द स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन एंड ट्राई टू मेक द टेबल. इफ यू आर एबल टू मेक द टेबल देन दैट्स इट. Try this question. We'll discuss this in the next lecture. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care. I think I'm exceeding the time now. Bye.